Hello everyone, welcome to Basics e-learning. In lesson number 9 video, I am going to discuss problems on how to sketch even an odd part of the given signal, that may be continuous time signal or a discrete time signal. All the questions that I am going to discuss in this video are previous semester paper questions. The first question here is, sketch the even and odd parts of the signal x of t. So this is the x of t signal given, that is a triangular signal. So to sketch the even and odd parts of the given signal x of t, so we know the formula here, x e of t is nothing but half of x of t plus x of minus t. So as you know x of t, we have to determine this x of minus t. So we need to sketch x of minus t. So it's a coordinate system. Here you are taking this as time scale and this is your x. So the first quadrant is x of t and this is minus t. So this is x of minus t, and this, as this is x and the negative side, the other side is minus x. So the third quadrant is minus of x of minus t and the fourth quadrant is minus x of t. So as you need to draw x of minus t, so that goes to your second quadrant. The given signal is here x of t, that is in the first quadrant. So you have to take the replica of, that is the mirror image of your x of t given signal along your vertical axis. So this will be your x of minus t, or else you can take it like this, time reversal property also. X of t is the signal that is extended from 0 to 2. So t has the range from 0 to 2. X of minus t means minus t will have the range, just take minus to the other side or else multiply with minus on both the sides. So this will have the range minus 0 to minus 2. So using time reversal property also, you will get the range of x of minus t is from 0 to minus 2. So this is your x of minus t. Now the formula says x of t plus x of minus t. So I need to add these two signals. That is, the total signal will be from minus 2 to plus 2. So at minus 2, I don't have any signal here on the negative axis, right? So negative t axis, or onto your left hand side, you don't have any signal. So as it is, this signal will be coming as the answer. Similarly, on your right hand side, there is no signal of x of minus t. So this part will be coming. So this x of t plus 0 gives you the same signal, but the amplitude is half. So instead of 1, it will be half here amplitude, right? So half of x of t plus x of minus t. So this is your x e of t. For the given x of t signal, try to draw x of minus t, then add both these signals, x of t and x of minus t, make the amplitude half. Similarly, to find out the odd part of the signal, we know x o of t is x of t minus x of minus t, right? So multiplied by half, right? So you know this is the signal x of t minus x of minus t. So you know this is x of t. So from this signal, you take the mirror image along the x-axis now. So just flip the signal along the x-axis. So then you will get this type of signal, right? With an amplitude of minus 1. Now, I need to add x of t and minus x of minus t. So if I add these two signals, I will get this waveform, right? That is extended from minus 2 to 2, right? Now, after adding, you have to make the amplitude to half. Earlier it will be, once you add, the amplitude will be minus 1 to 1. Once you make it half, so the amplitude is minus half to plus half, right? So this is how we can sketch the even and odd parts of the given triangular signal. The second question that I am going to discuss here is, sketch the even and odd parts of the given signal x of t. So the given signal x of t is of pulse form, extended from minus 1 to 2. Minus 1 to 1, it has an amplitude of 1. And 1 to 2, it has an amplitude of minus 1 here, right? So To calculate your even part of the signal, xe of t is half of x of t plus x of minus t. So, as you are given with x of t, we need to find out x of minus t. So, x of minus t, first we have to calculate the range. For t in x of t, the range is minus 1 to 2. So, minus t, the range will be 1 to minus 2. So, just multiply with minus on the both the ranges of the limit, right? So, the signal will be from minus 2 to 1. Or else, you can take it as a flip over your y-axis. So, just take the flip over x-axis, y-axis, then you will get the signal from minus 2 to minus 1 and then minus 1 to 1, right? So, like this you will be getting, right? Just take a flip on the y-axis. So, the given x of t, you take a flip on the y-axis, then you will get this type of signal, right? Or else you take the time reversal property. Then you will get the signal range from 1 to minus 2. See, 1 to minus 2, right? Now, you have to add x of t and x of minus t. See here at minus 2, I don't have any value for x of t. X of t value at minus 2, t is equal to minus 2 is 0. Here you have minus 1. Then at t is equal to minus 1, I have 0 and that is 1 here and then minus 1. So you will get it as 0. So the signal will be like this. That is, or else you can say minus 2 to minus 1. The signal is 0 for x of minus t, whereas you have a pulse of amplitude minus 1 for x of minus t. So, this signal will come, right? So, this part of the signal is added with a 0 amplitude. So, only this part you will get. But the amplitude has to become half. So, instead of minus half, I am taking the amplitude to, instead of minus 1, I am taking the amplitude to minus half between minus 2 to minus 1. Then, from minus 1 to 0, and then 0 to 1. See here, minus 1 to 1, I have a pulse with an amplitude of 1. Similarly, for x of minus t also, from minus 1 to 1, we have a pulse with amplitude 1. So, if I add x of t and x of minus t, I'll get a similar kind of pulse but with amplitude 2. As I have to make the amplitude to half, the amplitude will be of 1. The pulse is extended from minus 1 to 1 in your xe of then, the third part of the signal here is t is 1 to 2. When the t, you are taking the time limit is from t is equal to 1 to 2. I have a pulse with amplitude minus 1 here in x of t. In x of minus t, I don't have any pulse. So, the resultant will be of this type of pulse with an amplitude of minus 1, right? If I add these two, then as I have to make the amplitude to half, the amplitude will be minus half, right? So, finally, I'll get that xe of t is a signal after adding x of t and x of minus t. This is the signal that we are getting here. Similarly, for calculating xo of t is half of x of t plus x of minus of x of minus t, right? So, this is x of t you are given with minus of x of minus t. As you have already sketched your x of minus t. So, minus of x of minus t means take a flip over your time scale, that is on the x-axis. So, the down part will go up and the up part will come down. See here, see this down part is going up, that is minus 2 to minus 1. I have an amplitude of minus 1. Here it goes to minus 2 to minus 1, will have an amplitude of plus 1. Similarly, minus 1 to 1, I have an amplitude of 1 in x of minus t. Coming to minus x of minus t, it will have an amplitude of minus 1. Just take a flip on the t-axis. So, I'll get my x of minus t like this, right? So, this is my x of minus t. Now, we need to add x of t and x of minus of x of minus t and make the amplitude half. Again, divide the time scale into different ranges. So, I am taking it from minus 2 to minus 1. I don't have any pulse from minus 2 to minus 1 in x of t. But minus of x of minus t, we have a pulse of unit amplitude. Now, it will become a pulse of half the amplitude because After adding, you have to make the amplitude to half. Then, from minus 1 to 1, x of t has an amplitude of 1. Again, minus x of minus t, for t range minus 1 to 1, I have an amplitude of minus 1. So, 1 plus minus 1, you will get 0. So, that's why there is no pulse here from minus 1 to 1 in the resulting signal. Coming to t range from 1 to 2, x of t has an amplitude of minus 1 and I don't have any signal present here. T is 1 to 2. So, the same signal, this signal will be present here but with half the amplitude. So, at t is equal to 1 to 2, we have a pulse of half amplitude, right? That is nothing but minus half. So, this is the resulting xo of t for the given pulse signal. The next question is based on discrete time signal. Sketch the even and odd parts of the given signal x of n. So, this is your x of n you are given with. You have an amplitude at minus 2. N is equal to minus 2. You have an amplitude of 1. At n is equal to minus 1, amplitude is 2. At n is equal to 0, I have an amplitude of 3. Similarly, at n is equal to 7, you have an amplitude of 1. So, this is the signal given x of n. So, to find out the even part of the signal, that is xe of n, as you know the formula, just simply replace t by n. Xe of n is equal to half of x of n plus x of minus n. So, to find out x of minus n signal, take a flip over your y-axis, that is your here this vertical axis, right? So, take the flip, that means at n is equal to 7, you have a signal of 1. So, you take here at n is equal to minus 7, take an amplitude of 1. Similarly, minus 2 minus 1 goes to 1 and 2 here. 0 signal will be here as it is, right? So, now the x of minus n is like this signal, right? Now, xe of n, so it is nothing but add x of n and x of minus n at particular time intervals, n. So, at n is equal to minus 7, I don't have any signal here. So, but I have an amplitude of 1 here. So, as you have to make it half, amplitude will be 1 by 2 at n is equal to minus 7 at the resultant xe of n. So, at n is equal to minus 2, amplitude is 1 plus 0 in x of minus n. 1 plus 0 is 1 divided by 2. So, the amplitude is minus plus half at n is equal to minus 2. Similarly, for x of n, at n is equal to minus 1, I have an amplitude of 2 here. And I don't have any amplitude in x of minus n. You have 0 here. So, 2 plus 0 is 2 divided by 2 here. So, the amplitude is 1. So, this is the resultant impulse here. Then, at n is equal to 0, you have an amplitude of 3 and again 3. 3 plus 3 is 6 divided by 2. Again 3. So, you leave an impulse of 3 at n is equal to 0 in your xe of n signal. Similarly, at n is equal to 1 and 2, I don't have any amplitude in x of n. Whereas for x of minus n, the amplitudes are 2 and 1 respectively. So, if you make it half, you will get 1 and 1 by 2 at n is equal to 1 and 2 respectively. Right. Similarly, x of n, I am drawing one more time to find out xo of n. So, for that I need minus of x of minus n. So, as we know x of minus n, take a mirror image of this x of minus n over your x-axis. So, if you take a mirror image over this x-axis, so all the positive side impulses will go to the negative side impulses. So, at n is equal to minus 7, I have here amplitude of 1 that goes to minus 1 here. So, 3, 2, 1 respectively goes to minus 3, minus 2, minus 1 amplitudes here, right? So, this is minus 3, minus 2 and minus 1. Now, to find out xo of n, as we know the formula, half of x of n minus x of minus n. So, we need to add these two signals respectively at different n values. The amplitude of n is equal to minus 7 for x of n is 0, but here I have minus 1. So, 0 plus minus 1 is minus 1
then divided by 2, you'll have minus 1 by 2. Then from minus 6 to minus 3, I don't have any signal, right? So at n is equal to minus 2, I have an amplitude of 1 here. Here you have 0. 1 plus 0 is 0 divided by 2, right? 1 plus 0 is 1 divided by 2. So you will have 1 by 2. At n is equal to minus 2, I have an amplitude of 1 by 2. Similarly, at n is equal to minus 1, you have an amplitude of 2 and then 0. 2 divided by 0, you will have an amplitude of 1 at n is equal to minus 1. At n is equal to 0, I have an amplitude of 3 here, then minus 3, so 0 here, right? So at n is equal to minus 1, you have an amplitude of minus 2, right? So minus 2 divided by 2, you'll have an amplitude of minus 1 here. At here, you'll have minus 1. At n is equal to 2, I have an amplitude of minus 1. So this gives you minus half, right? So this is how to draw xe of n and xo of n.
For more videos, please do like, share, subscribe to our channel. Let us know your suggestions and queries in the comment box. Thank you.